Hello friend, welcome to Marine Engineering Hub. This is narrator, Chief Engineer Ravi Gupta. Today we are going to talk about glow valve. In today's video, we will see what is glow valve. After that, what are the type of glow valve? What are the material used in the glow valve? And after that, through a series of diagram, we will see how the glow valve look like when it has been throttled. And after that, we will see what are the overhauling procedure of glow valve and what thing need to be taken care when you are overhauling a glow valve. So let's start the today video about the glow valve. So basically, before starting the video, let's see the parts. So this is the hand wheel, which is help to rotate the valve to open and close it. This is the body of the glow valve, which is a bulbous bow type. And after that, this is the valve and this is the valve seat. And this is the bonnet, which is holding along with the bulbous bow. And this is the stuffing box or gland packing area. So this is a schematic diagram of a glow valve. As you can see, the water is coming from here. It will go up and it will go from here like this. Now, when the water is coming from here and flowing on top and going from here, at that time, this area is also filled with water. In order to prevent the water leaking from the stem side, the gland packing is provided. The gland packing which is provided is need to be kept in position, which is been held by the gland nut. And after that, in order to make the movement up and down, this hand wheel is been provided. And after that, this bulbous bow whole thing assembly is been held by the this bonnet. Okay, and now the most important area is this area. Now as you can see, this is the valve seat and this is the valve. This valve seat and valve are the main factor which help in providing the sealing. Now this valve seat and valve basically can be two type. How to what two type? So basically, when the stem, when it is welded to the valve, at that time, if the valve is open, at that time the valve will move along with the stem. Now the second type is that when the stem is not welded to the valve, at that time what will happen, when the stem will move up, when the glow valve is open and the stem will move up, the valve will be remain in the position. So that type of valve is called SDNR valve. So basically, as you can see, this is the one of type in which the valve is not welded to the stem, and here the valve is been welded to the stem. So these are the two type. One is the SDNR and one is the normal, okay, without SDNR. So these are two type of the non-intern valve. Screw down non-intern and normal non-intern. Okay, so now let's see. Now why it is called SDNR? Because it is screw down non-intern. It means that it is not been screwed and it is not directly attached, and when the water come from the other side, it will provide a sealing. Now as you can see here, the bulbous bow is basically is made of stellite. Okay, the seat is made of stellite in expensive one, and in some one it is made of cast steel. Now as you can see in this diagram, this is the water. When the glow valve is open condition, the water is coming from here, is going up and it is going like this. Now one more thing, suppose it is the SDNR type. So what will happen, the water will come from here, and as if the valve is open, please hear one more time, if the valve is open, because of the water pressure, it will lift the valve and it will go. Now if the valve is closed, it will not able to lift it. Second, now third is that if the water is coming from here, it will act as a sealing. So this diagram will be helpful for you. What I mean to say is this. Now suppose the water is coming from here and it is going like this and it is going like this. Okay. So what is happening? Water is coming from here. It is going like this and going like this, first condition. Now what is happening, suppose if it is a HDNR type. So the stem is in this position, the stem is in this position and the valve is in this position. So what will happen, it will loop it up and water will flow from here. Now suppose the water come from this side, so what will happen, so basically what will happen, the it will act on top and it will provide sealing. Okay, now this is the condition which look like when the valve is fully open, when it has been throttled. Now this you are seeing is basically the stem is attached with the valve, it is not HDNR. So as the valve stem is moving up, the valve is moving up, so the water is flowing and now it is becoming return type. The water can flow from both sides. Okay, now we are throttling it and now we are fully closed conditioned. It will look like this. So this is how by animation you can see the water flow is look like. It will go from here and will go from here, and this is the closed and this is the open condition. Now let's talk about overhauling of a glove valve. So as you can see in this picture, this is the basically bonnet, this is the bulbous body, this is the hand wheel, this is the valve and this is the stem and valve seat is inside, and this is the nut of a bonnet, this four nut, and this is the gland packing which I have talked about. So now let's see this. So this is the inside picture of a valve seat. Now you can see this is a valve seat, the valve seat is full not able to visualize. So whenever you are doing overhaul, the first thing we need to understand how you're gonna overhaul a glove valve. So as you can see in this diagram, the first thing you should do is that you need to open this bonnet nut. So first close the valve, first fully close the valve, then open the bonnet nut, second remove the bonnet on one side and this on the other side. So after that it will look like this. It will look like this. So now on top you can see the bulbous body and here you can see the valve seat. So this valve seat is need to be clean and after that it need to get a proper lapping via lapping paste. Now this is the HDNR type valve, this is the bonnet top part. So as I have told you here, as you can see in this diagram very clearly, so we have removed this part on one side, this part on bottom side. We can see from the, we are seeing from here on top, we are seeing from here, so we get to see the valve seat. After seeing the valve seat, what we are seeing, so we have to do the lapping. So now we have to do this lapping. After that we need to clean all this area and then we need to put this valve seat in the valve and valve seat, and then this we need to rotate it. Means basically as you can see here, this is a valve seat, we have placed the valve here, and now a wooden rod we can put here and we will rotate it in this direction and in this direction. After by rotation we'll do the lapping with the lapping paste, first with the coarse paste, after that with a fine paste till it becomes shining and there is no scratch mark or any dent in the valve seat because that is a sealing area. After that this is the valve seat, basically the bottom part this part is mainly the sealing area. Now this is the basically HDNR type. Okay, HDNR type. So as you can see, so what is happening, this part is basically a guide for top and bottom movement. Okay, and the spindle which is there from top here, it can move maximum to this position. Now when it is open, it will be in this position, and when it is coming up with the water pressure, it will come here. Okay, so one more time I will tell you, this is the guiding part of the valve. Okay, which will be get inside the valve seat, and after that this is the area which is acting as a sealing area. Okay, and now the spindle or stem is here normally in the open condition, and this is the area on which is the playing area on which it will open and close depending upon the water pressure. Okay, so now this is the stem which I'm talking about. The valve will come here like this. Okay, it will like this, and this will up down, it will move. Okay, Now this we need to clean, and after that we need to clean all the rust, and after that we need to change the gland backing. So after doing this whole thing, it will look like this. So now you can see when the seat is clean, it will be shining like this. And after that, this is how when it properly clean, it will shine like this. And this is a guide, and this is the stem. Now bonnet you have removed, this you have removed, but how to take out this? So now it is very easy. As you can see here in the diagram, you will understand. In the diagram, if you see how to remove, so basically what you have to do, first I have told you, first remove the bonnet cover, and foremost you need to close, first put the spindle in a closed condition, and after that open this bonnet nut and remove the this part other side, this part other side, and then this part will come as a whole, this part will come as a whole. Now as you can see, the dia here is less and dia here is more. So what you need to do, basically you need to rotate it in the anti-clockwise direction and will come out from bottom side. Here one more time, what I mean to say, so what is basically happening, the dia on the top is less, the dia on the top bottom is more. So you have to rotate it in the anti-clockwise. It means when you are, the way it will come out anti-clockwise, it will rotate and it will come from the downside along with the stem. Now before that you remove the handwheel, of course. So this is how you will do the overhauling of a globe valve. So what you have to do, after opening you have to change gland backing, and after that properly lapping, and then you fit back and check, do the leak test. How you will do the leak test? So basically you fill it with the water, and after filling with water you see from the other side, discharge side, if the water is leaking or not. If the water is leaking, it means the valve is not holding, then you have to do again the lapping properly. So this is how the globe valve has been overhauled. Friends, if you have learned something from this video, please do like and subscribe, and please do share our video. If you want to know about gate valve, I will be uploading in upcoming video. And if you want to know about pressure reducing valve or quick closing valve working, please do find the link in the description box, or you can go to the playlist of valves and you can find the different type of valve overhauling features and where it is used, why it is used. So this globe valve is generally a non-intern valve, and it is in use in most of the places, and this is why you need to know how to overhaul a globe valve. Because onward, when you go as a fourth engineer, fifth engineer, even as a third engineer, you need to know how to overhaul a globe valve, because sometimes company will not provide, because some globe valve are very expensive and hard to get. So you need to know how to do the overhauling. If you have learned something from this video, please do like, please subscribe, and don't forget to share. Thank you.